नमस्ते स्टूडेंट्स, इन दिस लेक्चर वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द न्यूट्रिशन एंड इट्स टाइप्स। सो व्हाट इज न्यूट्रिशन? न्यूट्रिशन मींस दैट द इनटेक ऑफ द न्यूट्रिएंट्स, एंड बाय द इनटेक ऑफ द न्यूट्रिएंट्स वी विल गेट एनर्जी। सो व्हाट आर द वेरियस न्यूट्रिएंट्स दैट वी टेक इन द फॉर्म ऑफ फूड? दैट आर कार्बोहाइड्रेट्स, fats, vitamins, minerals, proteins and water, etc. So these are the important nutrients that should be present in our food for obtaining energy. Now next we will discuss about the modes of nutrition. Now what are modes of nutrition? What is the meaning of this term? It means that how we obtain the food. So there are two categories. The first one that are the autotrophic mode of nutrition, and the second one that are the heterotrophic mode of nutrition. So autotrophic mode of nutrition that include the autotrophs, which can prepare their own food from the simple inorganic molecules like carbon dioxide and water in the presence of sunlight and chlorophyll by the process of photosynthesis. Like green plants, all the green plants, they come under this. All green plants, even the photosynthetic bacteria also. Photosynthetic bacteria. Okay, and if suppose we will talk about the heterotrophic mode of nutrition, so it involves the heterotrophs, which cannot make their own food by the process of photosynthesis, and they depend upon the autotrophs. Okay, so they depend upon the autotrophs for their food. For example, like ticks, mites, tapeworms, roundworms, they will come under the parasites, and the other organisms like the decomposers, okay, and all other organisms like the cat, dog, lion, deer, human beings. So they come under the heterotrophic mode of nutrition. So there are various types of the heterotrophic mode of nutrition also. So what are the important types? Like saprotrophic, parasitic and holozoic mode of nutrition. Saprotrophic nutrition means that including the saprotrophs, which obtain their food from dead remains of plants and animals. For example, fungi and bacteria. And if suppose we will talk about fungi, so it includes bread molds, mushroom, yeast, etc. Now next, that are parasitic. It involves the parasites, which depend upon the host body for their survival. Means they obtain their nutrition from the living organism without killing them. Okay, so examples that are ticks, mites, leeches, tapeworm, roundworms, cuscuta, plasmodium, etc. So those parasites which feed over the surface of the host body, they are known as the ectoparasites, and which enter the host body and then they affect the body, but they do not kill them. So they are considered as the endoparasites. Now next we will discuss about the holozoic mode of nutrition. It includes 5 steps of nutrition: ingestion, digestion, absorption, assimilation, digestion. So these five steps of nutrition, they will come under the holozoic mode of nutrition. Like first step, that is ingestion, taking of the food, then digesting it, then that digested food, it will be absorbed by the blood into the cells, and then these cells, they are responsible for getting energy from this digested food, and then the undigested food, it will be removed from the body through the digestion process. So means when the nutrition, it occurs in these five steps, then that mode of nutrition is known as the holozoic mode of nutrition. For example, in case of cat, dog, human beings, lion, deer, etc.